All right, welcome back to lesson 9 in our tune-in guitar lesson series. This is it. This is the last lesson. Let's warm up. Let's warm up with something fun. I want to see if we remember all the things we learned. Do we remember our alternate picking exercise with our Kings of Leon song, Notion? Right? So we got notes on the B string here, and then we're also alternating with zero on the E string. We're using that old chestnut. So 5, 5, 5, 4, 2, 2, 2, 10, 9, 9, 9, 12, 7, 7, 10, 9. Hopefully you guys have been practicing. And remember, this is kind of like a 16th note groove. So we gotta find the right tempo. One E and a two E and a three and a four E and a one E and a two E and a three and a four E and a. Sorry, hearing it before we do it. This is getting close to album speed. 2 E and a 3 and a 4 E and a. I think that might be past album speed. Let's try it right there. 70 BPM. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 and a 4 E and a. A little fast for you? Me too. Let's try it right. 60. 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 E and a 4 E and a. Feeling warmed up? Do you remember our open power chords, our open bar chords from last time in the key of E? This song, that song we were just playing, is in the key of E, which is why we can use that open E string to great effect. Right? Just works. This song is fun. It's the chords are E, right? An A, but we can play A with our open strings like we learned last lesson. So 2 on the D string, 2 on the G string, but leaving the B string and the E strings open to sound great. And we're gonna grab this C sharp chord, basically making a 3-string power chord on the 4th fret of the A string there, right? And still including those open B and E strings. And then to B, so then we just move that down 2. C sharp, C, B. And so that's kind of how that Kings of Leon songs go, but it's great to just have a progression where you can rock those chords with the open strings. Not. So that's a trick. Can you play on the offbeat? So that's how that song goes in the chorus. Don't knock it if you've been here before. So what am I doing? I'm doing an upstroke on every and beat. So that's a kind of a fun trick. And right? And so it's kind of right between the kick and the snare there. There's a hi-hat in between. One, and. So that's a really good trick to be able to do, to just play, be able to play on the offbeat, that's called, right? So the downbeat, right? One, two, three, four. But there's a beat in between there, and we can just play it in between. So we go one, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and. And I do an upstroke, because it's kind of, it gives it a sharper kind of like sound, right? As opposed to if I were to do downstrokes, then it would kind of like be all grumbly. One and two and three and four and one, right? It doesn't quite have the same effect. So it's nice to do upstrokes. Pretend you're in a reggae band. If you're in a reggae band, you might cut it off, right? Remember, you can cut off notes with your palm here. Yeah, but see if we can play the whole progression through four times on the ands. One, and two, and switch to A, C sharp, B. So get some practice playing those chords with rhythm. Hopefully you remembered how to play Notion, that sweet riff. I love that riff. Do you remember how to play Smells Like Teen Spearmint? Right, so we learned power chords, right? So there's two string power chords with just two strings, the bottom string and then the next string up two frets. We can tune that into a three-string power chord by adding our pinky again, right, on the string right below our ring finger. But then that's our power chord, right? And then if we want to play Nirvana, we do one on the E string to one on the A string, and then four on the E string to four on the A string. And then if you want to play the sweet verse part, you can get some practice working on your barring finger, barring those two strings at once with your index finger on the first fret. And if you got a tremolo arm, you can have fun with that. Do we remember how to play hardest button to button, right? That's when we learned our three-string power chords. So we got, right? So remember, we got A string, G string, D string, A string, and then cut it off. And then moving it up to three, the same three-string power chord, but this time we're only playing the strings our fingers are on, right? We're not using those open strings. Him a toy. It was a ray gun, and it was 1981. We called him Baby. He had a toothache. He started crying. It sounded like an earthquake. It didn't last long, 'cause I stopped it. We get a ray gun, stuck some little pins in it. Now we're a family, and we're all right now. Money and a little place to fight now. And we don't know you, and we don't owe you. But if we see you around, we might have something else to show you. Hardest button to button. Hopefully you can play that great song. Do we remember how to play Seven Nation Army? Right, so if we're using our finger on the bass note, we're going 7, 7, 10, 7, 5, 3, 2. Right, and if we're playing with our slide, or we want to play that like nice chunky chord on the middle strings, right? And we got to move it up 2 frets to 9. So I'm kind of aiming for those nice 2 chunky notes on the bottom, but it's okay if that top note gets in there too. Nine, 12, 9, 7, 5, 4. Right, and then there's that build up, there's that turnaround section in that song, which is G, 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 A, 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 right? That's kind of the turnaround. So how we can play those as power chords, right? So 3 on the E string, make a power chord there. And move that up to 5. Right, and then you're back into the riff. And then if you want to learn the solo to that song, you're going to go up to the 12th fret, this E note up here. So you're actually, you're going to be 12 and 15. You cannot like imagine like this is an octave up, right, from here, from 0, right? So 0. You're kind of using the same notes that we're learning in open position here, but an octave up. So that's going to be one I'm going to leave for you. If you want to figure out the solo and you know where to start, I totally bet that you could figure out the solo using your ear. Okay, so we started learning this one. This one's for bonus points. All right? So before we got you as far as this open power chord, right? I like to get the 3-finger version. Nice and chunky, right? So I'm gonna teach you one other kind of open string power chord here. This one's got a bit of a trick to it, so that's why it's extra credit. So we're gonna go for this open G power chord, which has like this G note on the 3rd fret there on the E string, but gonna grab the open. So at this point, like the open string is the higher string, this A string. So we want those strings to rowing together. That sounds really good, right? But the only problem is we've got this A string kind of in the way. So if you hear that A string ringing in there, it's not the best, right? It doesn't really add to our chord. So the trick is, can you lightly sort of just touch the A string with your middle finger here that's already on the E string? Right, so it's kind of being muted. I'm actually getting a harmonic there, which I don't want. Yeah, so we want a little more muted like that. So then that note's not getting in the way. So now it's just the 2 notes. Even though that A string's in the middle, I'm kind of just muting it. So that's a bit of a trick. That's another one of those things that you're gonna have to practice on your own using finesse. Just kind of, just lightly, you're gonna have to change your angles, changing the way you're resting your hand. Right? And then using your right hand, right? Your right hand is a big, I mean, your right hand is what actually makes the music, right? There's an old adage, right? So, and when I'm talking about this, I'm talking about right-handed people, right? Who are playing guitar the traditional way. But so this hand, your fretting hand, probably your left hand, this is what you know, right? So this is like, you have to know the notes. You got to know where to put this, right? This is what you know. This hand, then your strumming and your picking hand, right? This is what actually makes the music. This is what makes the sound that people hear. So it's actually kind of more important. But it's that always that trick of like, how can I know what to play and like learn how to play it, but how can I like also remember, you know, when to play it and like what kind of technique I'm using, right? We want to make sure that like the right string of the chord is on the bottom. So this is all just like little fidgety things that you're going to have to like kind of work on yourself to just make yourself sound better, man. Like if you are listening to yourself, like listen to yourself. That's my challenge to you. Don't just make noise. Can you make noise and listen at the same time? That is like the great challenge of being a musician. Right. So then we're trying to get this open power chord like that. By muting the A string with our ring with my middle finger here, and then also, so we're just getting, I'm just moving that bottom note 2-2-3, and then keeping that D string, right? So I'm still muting this A string, right? So A A A, right? With our big open power chord, A A A. Then we got 2-2-3 with the open D string. Then we go what? 2-2-3, 2-2-3, 2-A-A. Right, that's the whole thing. So that's a really good technique to learn, to like be able to mute a string in the middle like that. That's like extra credit if you can do that. If that's not working for you right now, we can also do this. We can do a normal power chord, right? On three. So there's my G note and there's my power chord note, right? And then right? So that's a D note. That's why I'm fretting that note, because that's getting the same note as this open string here, right? And then the same thing, I'm just moving that bottom note to 2-2-2-3. So it's a bit of a stretch, but it might be easier than trying to mute that middle note, right? So that's another way to do it. A, 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 2-2-3. Before it goes to the chorus, 2-2-3-2-E-E. We go to an E major chord, build that up. I'm on the high A to D, G D highway to D, G D highway to D. 2-3. Right back into it. So you might notice, I like doing this, especially when I'm just writing those low strings, I'm going for those low chunky notes. I'll do an A like that, right? Because I'm not too interested in those high notes coming through. That's a big part of like what I'm doing with my right hand, especially with this AC/DC stuff, those nice chunky chords. I'm really aiming for the low notes, and I'm kind of like arcing, right? You can strum, some people just aim for all six strings at once. It sounds like they're hitting it with a stick or something, right? So you kind of want to aim where you want to ride the tip of your pick, right? With your right hand, and get them kind of like floating across there with control. And you can also like angle out, right? So that like if I'm aiming for the low strings, I've got that kind of accent where I'm, you almost have to imagine, like, what's your angle gonna be, right? So I'm totally, the way that's going, I'm kind of just hitting these middle three strings, right? Because I'm also, I'm aiming to not hit the low E note, right? And I'm basically aiming for the open A string and the D string and the G string. That's where those AC/DC nice chunky strings are. So you're really gonna find that, like, your right hand, right? Like, you know, if you wanna, like, play like AC/DC, like, really aggressively, right? It's kind of just about aiming. You're gonna have to, like, learn to aim with your pick, right? And the more you can, like, aim with accuracy, and then, like, and then you can start playing aggressively like you really want. But at first you might have to kind of just be careful, right? Find a method to just hit the strings you want, and then as you get better at that, then you can get, like, more aggressive. Right, so that's because my aim's getting good, I can play aggressively and still hit the strings I want. So that's what you also have to work on. That's your job, because I can't hear you, right? Listen to yourself. How can you make it more musical, right? I can tell you, I can show you what to play, but you're the one hearing yourself. And believe in your feedback, right? If you like what you're hearing, that's great. If you don't like what you're hearing, please take the time to change it. Tune your guitar, adjust your fingers. See if you can, like, if you play it softer with your right hand, is it easier? Try all those things. So, Highway to Hell, we finally made it. Yeah. We are gonna quickly check out the notes on the A string and the E string with our last lesson. Not too worried about reading these, right? We're not, this isn't a heavy reading course, but we do sort of wanna, my goal with, like, having you read the notes is again, can you play and then be aware at the same time? Can you play and then concentrate on something else at the same time as playing? That's the great challenge. So last time we learned the D string, now we're on the A string. So we got A, we're gonna skip this accidental note, A sharp, go straight to B, and then B goes straight to C. So we got A, B, and C on the A string. For reading, this gets, like, a little bit tricky because now we're below the staff, right? You remember, like, the D, that was, like, the space right below the staff, right? This C note is middle C. It's, like, a big note for the piano, and it's gonna be right below the D note, in, you know, underneath the staff, and it's gonna have a line through it. Right, so to remind you that there's a line there, an imaginary line. So there, it's below the staff of five lines, and it's below the D note, and it's got a little line through it, because remember, these notes are still alternating on the musical staff, line, space, line, space. So that note right there, that C note, is like middle C. It's just, it's got one line through it. That B note is gonna be right below that C note, obviously, and then so it's gonna have the line right above it to show you that there's a line there, and this is on the space below it. And then this A note is gonna be, it's gonna be below that, and then it's gonna have a line through it, so you're gonna see it's gonna have a line through it, and then another line there to remind you that there's these imaginary lines between the staff. So A, B, C on the A string. And then for this E string again, it's gonna be the same as the high E string, the same notes, right? E, F, G. And then we're getting further and further below the staff, so these notes get crazier and crazier looking, right? So this is G, this is gonna be, like, right below that imaginary line that the A was on, right? So the A has a line through it, and then another line above it. And then, so this is gonna be right below those two imaginary lines on a space. And then F is gonna be on a line before that even, right? And then E is gonna be on a space before that. So E is gonna have it's going to be on a space, and there's going to be a line right above it, and then another line above it, and then another line above it, to remind you of those three invisible imaginary lines that we have to imagine when we're underneath the music staff. So there you go. Those are all the notes in open position that you can read in musical notation now. There you go. All six strings. I would love to write a song with you. I kind of promised you that we're going to hopefully give you some tools to write your own song. So here we go. This is a crash course in writing your songs. If you're writing a song, it's good to like know what key you're in. If you know what key you're in, then you can use some musical theory to kind of help you. And this is sort of the same idea we talked about last time using when we switched from letters to numbers, right? Where if you know what key you're starting in, then you can switch everything to numbers. So there's a little formula involved in making a major scale. And it's called the tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone formula. So what does that mean? Music is divided up into semitones, right? So if you see a piano, one note after the other, they're all going up by one semitone. And the same with the guitar. Every time I move up a fret, I'm going up by one semitone. A whole tone is basically two semitones, so that's like skipping one, right? So a whole tone is skipping a fret on the guitar. So if we were to use tone, right? So we're gonna use C as an example. We're gonna start in the key of C, right? So C is our starting note. If we go up a tone, right, that's skipping a fret. So tone, tone, semitone. So moving on to one. Tone, 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 right? Skipping frets and then semitone. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. So, what do we have? We have a scale when we figure that out. And because it's C doesn't have any accidentals. C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. If we were to like count up all the notes, right? C, C sharp, D, right? So that's all the notes in the key of C. And then there can be chords that go along with those notes. So this is the beginning of what's called diatonic harmony. And basically all that means is we can make a family of chords where all those chords, all the notes in those chords are in C major scale. And then so they all kind of go together and you can write a song with those chords. So this isn't the end all. There's no rules to writing music. Like you're going to hear songs and write songs on your own that like deviate from this, right? But this is a good place to start to get the fundamentals. And then, you know, it's always nice to have a nice place to like jump from when you're improvising and trying new things. It's nice to have like something you know works, and then you can sort of jump from there to see if anything else works, right? So that's what we're doing. So C D E F G A B C, right? That's like 7 degrees of the scale, and then you start again at the first here, right? Do re mi fa sol la ti, and then you back at do. But each of those degrees in the scale can have a chord that goes with it. And there's a formula for that too. So the first chord is major, right? Because it's major scale, C major. The second chord is minor. The third chord is minor. The fourth chord is major. The fifth chord is major, right? The sixth chord is minor. And the seventh chord is kind of jazzy. We're not gonna worry about that for this course. And then you're back at C. So how did I, if you remember our bar chord lesson from last time, I was playing C as a C bar chord here, barring an A, right? So I made an A chord here. I barred it on C. Right, so that's a major, right? And then to D, but I want that one to be minor, so that I have to change my fingers to make a A minor shape here, right? Because now I'm taking A minor and barring it. Right, so just because we're using the same string here, so major, right? Major's the hard one where you have to get all three strings on the same fret. It's really tough. Minor, right, is a little bit easier. Minor. So it's C major, D minor, E minor, F major, right? That's me doing that tricky major bar chord. G major, A minor. Look, so that's, I'm barring an A chord on the octave, right? So I could even just play it there. So we're just gonna go 1 through 6 for now. We're gonna forget about that jazzy 7 chord. So that means in our diatonic chord family, we have the chords C major, D minor, E minor, F major, G major, A minor, right? And I just played all those chords differently than I did before. There's all kinds of different ways to play chords. So now that we've got our diatonic chord family, we can basically mix and match those chords to create a song if we want. We just know that they're gonna work. And then so if we kind of mix and match them and we hear something we like, then we're on our way to sort of writing a song. So just to show you how easy it is, we're gonna, Robbie, can I have 3 random numbers between 1 and 6? between 1 and 6, we're gonna skip 7 for now. 3, 4, 6? Okay, so 3, 4, 6. So that this is crazy because, it's not crazy, but you'll notice he didn't choose 1, right? So it's pretty normal for, like, if you're writing a song in C, it's pretty normal to, like, have the C chord in there, but you don't have to, right? So 3, 4, 1. So he's basically saying, he said in the third degree of the scale, right? So that's E. And it's minor. So we're gonna have an E minor chord. Let's play the easy way. E minor chord, remember that, right? And you said 3, 4, 6, right? Yeah, right? So E minor, 4 chord is F, right? Barring my E major on the first fret there. F, and then 6, right? A minor. So those are the 3 chords he suggested, so I'm gonna start playing a song. So that's me playing F, E minor, and F. Kind of share a bar, right? E minor, 2, F, 4, then A minor. Had a great time making these videos. I've really had a great time getting excited about guitar with you. Robbie really wrote a pretty sad song. It's kind of getting me down right now, but it's definitely got a vibe. Right, so there's a million, you can just tell that they those chords go together, right? And I just kind of made that up on the spot, but you could take those and you could play them really aggressively. Or you could fool around with the timing of them, right? But the point is that we learned sort of a formula of chords that go together, and then you can mix and match that. Let's try. We're gonna pick a different key now. Let's pick G. So if we do our tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone formula, we're gonna get tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone. We get G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G, right? And then we can, make, let's get three more random numbers, Robbie. 251, this is a jazzer right there. So 251 is like every jazz song ever written almost. So two, what's the second chord is A, right? G, A minor. So A minor, the fifth chord is D. So one, two, three, four, five, D. We know how to play a D chord, right? What are you, 251, and then G, right? So G's our one chord. So we got a song. So there's a little ditty too. The other way to get it kind of like more interest out of these is you can, with like the two and three, mix those up between minor and major, right? So the way to make all the chords in the same, have the notes in the same scale is to follow the formula I gave you, which is one minor, one major, two minor, three minor, four major, five major, six minor. But you can sort of switch those minors and majors up for some really fun ideas. So if we did two major, right, instead of minor, 251, so. So you get some kind of Beatles-y stuff when you start adding like a major. Or you could do like a major three, right? So instead of, we have G, A minor, B minor would be our minor three. But if you could do a major, right? So then you've probably heard stuff like this before. So that major three, you can hear what a powerful note that is. So I hope that you have fun writing your own songs. Remember, that's just like sort of a good starting place, but any, you know, like when that song came out, people didn't think that was very good musical theory. People didn't think those chords went together. They, a lot of people told Kurt Cobain that song wasn't very good, but he just felt it in him. He just loved hearing it. He loved playing it. And it became a massive, massive hit, right? So there's no rules. But I hope you're creating on the guitar. I hope that you're not just playing what you're told. So, what else we got left? Do we remember how to play Fast Car? Whoa. Sorry there, guitar. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna play all of Fast Car together to wrap this up because it's my favorite song, and that's why I teach guitar, so that I can play the song with people. So we all know the song now. You ready to play it? note that I'm playing it without a capo because it's easier for me to sing that way. You got a fast car, I got a ticket to anywhere. Maybe we'll make a deal, maybe together we can get somewhere. Any place is better, starting from zero, got nothing to lose. Maybe we can make something. Me, myself, I got nothing to prove. You got a fast car, I got a plan to get us out of here. I've been working at a convenience store, managed to save just a little bit of money. Won't have to drive too far, just cross the border and into the city. You and I can both get jobs, find the sea, what it means to be living. See, my old man's got a problem. He lives with the bottle, that's the way it is. He said his body's too old for working, his body's too young to look like his. My mama went off and left him, she wanted more from life than he could give. I said somebody's gotta take care of him, so I quit school and that's what I did. Got a fast car, is it fast enough that we can fly away? We gotta make a decision, leave tonight or live and die this way. So remember when we were driving, driving in your car, speed so fast, felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling that I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. Ourselves, you still ain't got a job. And I work in the market as a checkout girl. I know things will get better. You'll find work and I'll get promoted. We'll move out of the shelter, buy a big house and live in the suburbs. So remember when we were driving, driving in your car, speed so fast, felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling like I belonged. I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. I got a job that pays all our bills. You stay out drinking late at the bar, see more your friends than you do your kids. I'd always hoped for better, thought maybe together you and me'd find it. I got no plan, I ain't going nowhere, so take your fast car and keep on driving. Driving in your car, speed so fast, felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And Thanks so much for doing this course with me. I had a lot of fun. I hope you did too.